different. I've recently planted apple red spur, which is patio apple, but we'll go in the saddle just as well. And hopefully we'll get fruit before they're much older. These are only about 2 years old. They're not bare root, these are pots, so don't need the same amount of soaking of the roots. No, literally. I want to leave the grafting. This is the grafting, I want to leave that just proud. So I don't want it to rot. There are a few roots I might have to contend with later, including the dreaded barnweed. Now really, I need to get a cane for that. So I'll get one in before I finish. So the next one I'm going to plant, I don't know if you can see that, that's a golden spur apple, some sort of age. Oh, I'm grafted onto rootstock, I think it is anyway. I'll have this in. Now the problem we've got here is a lot of roots from trees and bushes already in situ. We might be competing for resource, but you see the ground's very wet at the moment being winter. And we do get flooding down here, but we do have drainage as well, put in by someone who had the allotment previously, which we'll have a look at later. I'm having plenty of root, plenty of loose soil around. Even though the plant's not that big, there's a bit of storm there. There it is, it's a brick. What's that got down there? Okay. There's plenty of loose earth with it being dug out for the roots to expand into. Just hope they're not competing too much with what's here already. These need 3/4 of a metre between plants, so I'll give them more than that. I'll probably put three trees. I put four in this plot, I think. So, bang, back it up. But I don't want the stone back in. Trusty mattock. That's about right. Not too tight. We'll be watering these in thoroughly shortly afterwards. So try not to get the crown to rot. I don't know if I'm talking sense or if I'm talking rubbish, but it sounds right to me. Vague recollections from books. Okay. Not really much in the way of cane at the moment. Just pick up the old pots that we're not using, including any rubbish. Next to go in is a Prunus avium sylvia, and you can see that there. Now, what kind is that, you might ask? I can't remember, so you have to Google it. This one is somewhat pot bound, so the sooner I can get this in, the better. But this one comes with a cane. This is ideal. Plenty of room here. Let's say we'll take plenty out. Very heavy clay soil. Here we have. And I'll just dig wider so there's plenty of loose earth for the roots to push through next year. We've got plenty of other things. Also, some lovely earthworms. Let's have a look for height. Look how high that. I did read from an author, from a respectable source, not to put compost in. So there's still a lot of roots, there's going to be a lot of weeds, there's going to be a lot of weeding goes on, especially next year. We're revisiting this plot to tidy up even more. So we've got a good at least 3/4 of a metre between plants, because they have a 1.5 metre spread. Being patio plants, I think we'll have one more.
It's cool.
Or a pair. Next up is the dwarf pear lily pup. Something just here. Try not to dig too deep. I don't want to risk breaking the shaft of the spade. So we'll widen that all out a bit so it can spread their roots. There's been a lot of stuff dug into this in the past. Spread out one bit further. And then we'll put it back in. I'll put that over there actually. We'll see how these get on. The available light in the summer, so they will be shining straight on them from dawn for about 6 hours at least in the summer months. Right, just stake them now. And water them in. Okay, so we've got some canes. I mean, these will be fine for the size of these. I mean, this one's actually got a cane already, but we'll probably put an extra one in. So I'll clear the root ball as where it was by going diagonally for now. I'll probably do so again. Yeah. And I need to get a cap for these before I have someone's eye out. It's probably not right. But I don't get it near. That's all on this. But, well, this one's a bit. We'll bang at least one on there. Get some more. I'll just do it loose. I think I should have brought a knife.
Yeah. I'll pull it to you, chop it.
You can't pull it, oh yeah. This one. I see, I could probably put other stuff in it, okay. It's Robinson. Is it? Yeah, that's fine. Okay, next up is a plum black amber, which can go.
Thanks.
No, because the sun comes in, the trees will shade it earlier on in day. You're not very big, look, dwarf trees. So we'll just get the hole bigger than it really needs to be, so it's loose soil for it to grow into. No, we're done now. Just have a mattock. Versatile. Mattock. Isn't going to be big enough in the long term to see through the winter storms, in my honest opinion. Oh, yeah, it's just a little spike. Man, they put the spike. I don't want that root in there. actually this one will be alright for now. I think it's actually gonna slot through it there. There. That'll do it for now. So I'm going to finish with two blueberries because I'm going to reserve that end for rhubarb, and I've got a gooseberry bush coming, but that can go in the end. The last. Thank you. So we'll have a just burn, shall we? It's alright now.
What about my gardener's gloves? They're like gauntlets.
Yeah.
You know my big thick suede ones?
Yeah. No, I think we're alright. See how your nice galvanized finish soon disappears, doesn't it? Choo-choo. So this behemoth is the biggest paddle, and I think that's going to be at the back. We managed to stand it up, and it's in good condition. It's just got a few bits, a few gaps, and then we've got smaller panels. And it looks like something with windows in it down there. So we'll just lie this down over there for now. Or we might put it back here because we can get up again. We know what we're doing. It's easy now. Easy, man.